Where are we, Simone, please?
We are in San Giuliano, near Barbarano Romano.
Taking some footage here of this cave, well, dwelling, possible tomb place down here. Traversing down the steps, some hollows up to the side here, coming through this doorway where it's wider at the bottom, it's narrower at the top. Wider at the bottom, it's narrower at the top.
Where it's wider at the bottom, it's narrower at the top. Where it's wider at the bottom, it's narrower at the top.
Notice the trapezoidal doors and windows, Italy. Here we see trapezoidal doors and windows, Peru. From my point of view, there's definitely more than meets the eye with these trapezoidal windows and doorways. Indeed, within the tomb of Orghieri in Italy, you can see that trapezoidal door, and you can see the two participants at the outside. And just look at the way they're gesturing. Indeed, above that door, you can also see the two lions, and there would be something in the center there also, the triptych in a way. But nonetheless, we can now move to Egypt, and if you look within this configuration from Egypt, you can kind of see that doorway as well. And if you look further within the stuff in Egypt, you can see the working of that also in a way. But that's a video for another time. Let's get back to our tour. Doorway where it's wider at the bottom, it's narrower at the top. Coming through the pattern around the doorway, the triptych with the, in this case, the angular triangle type shapes, the ceiling uniformly ribbed like this, all hewn though out of the one rock bed. The same applies in this deeper chamber. In this deeper chamber, you have the four pillars in a way, with the head, and you can see the decoration about the head. Very interesting. This one lies in this direction, the other one lies in the other direction, with what is perhaps the area there where the head would be. So, just a quick look at what is going on here. And heading out. A quick go into this further cavern edifice here. It's wet on the floor, but just a bit of a look through. Again, it's wet, so I'm not going to go right through, but looks like the positions up the back to the left and the right, bed type setup. With this site, it's just interesting to see on the hillside here. In this case, this is the only part we can see of this cornicing, this fascia. Below, we have these dwellings or edifices into the rock here, just around outlook onto the further, what is a rather steep ravine through here. We were just looking at the fascia across the hillside here, and now we're looking at this area down here. There's a greater diagram here. Interesting design there, the way it's juxtaposed. with the positive and negative, some pottery that has been retrieved, no doubt, from this area. And here is a shot of this huge excavation down below. Within this site, there are the stairways here leading up onto this platform region. We come around, stairs there, and then quite a numerous amount of stairs leading down towards a riverbed further down below. Okay, further along the cliff face here, and the cornice-like work comes through here and then turns a right angle corner and heads this way. It's extremely overgrown. Below, no doubt tunnels going under. So this is going to head down and under this here. Coming around. More tunnels in here, stairs going up, major rocks right directly above, sculpting on the walls here. The cornice work following the face around. Here is some local information on the sign. We've just backed out and now having a look at what is quite a huge structure here with quite sizable delineation of this many will term doorway to nowhere type configuration, for want of another way to put it. And up here also within the rock, this design, you can see the corner of it there, that would be to face our left as we see it. But there is another one through here above the smaller entranceways. The sign for the structure here, the official version, is saying Queen's Tomb, first quarter of the 5th century BC, large shaped, talking about the containing four funerary beds, Etruscan architecture, and so forth. Okay, so we're at this region here, and this actually depicts a dog tussling with a deer. Now we're just going to go into this tomb here. You can see the fascia up above. You can see it up in here. Also traverses around the bush. Within this shot here, you can see the fascia here. It's also through here, and then this is a good example of right up further, the fascia is on the kind of next level above, also going up this side of the ravine. Heading up this gully here, we have now crossed from the other side where we were. You can see the workmanship up on this side. It's pretty definite within the wall. And now we head up through this roadway. You can see the working of stone. Capturing the signs, capturing just information about where we are. Here is the map. Here in Italy. Through here, so you have this old roadway through here, and then much through the through here the inferior wall construction, a newer wall construction up here. Just looking at the sign for a moment, and among other things, it gives us an idea of where we are as far as maps go and so forth. This is the writing in English. Now, just within the logo, it's just interesting that I didn't notice it before, but you have the concentric magic circle type configuration right there, even with the center of it, with the symbology there. Quite interesting. All right, so in this region, the wall I showed just earlier is here, this new wall for reference. Just having a look inside here for a moment, and it goes back about 15 meters or so. Coming around this way.
Connection from this side to the other.
And yet another large cavernous wall within here. You can see the scrape marks here. Here is a good example of the scrape marks going one way and then the other, in this case kind of forming a Vesica Pisces type design within there. Whether intentional or not, or just more, I would suspect, just part of the workings on the walls here, is a good indication of what's going on with the construction in a way. Here is a bit of a close-up of the markings on the wall. Up this, what would be most probably quite an ancient roadway coming through here, markings to the side of it and around, but there's this hole going through here. This goes through about 10 meters or so, it looks like, on the side and up above. Okay, this church in San Giuliano still has its dated from, according to this, from the 12th century BC. And we'll just go in and have a look. We're just going to have a look at the murals that still remain in here. There are pews still in here. And the construction, there are odd things in the construction. So it's obviously been rebuilt. Doorways have been put in. The lintel over the doorway here is made of a wood, piece of wood, whereas this one is stone. And then this one differs. So a lot of hodgepodging going on here. Pillar. You'll notice that quite, there's differences here, there, and everywhere. But nonetheless, this part is protected within here, and I'll do my best to get a shot through. Just to quickly point out here that you have the ore around the Christ figure with the four around the one represented here, represented. Within here, you have an ore also around the participant, one of the participants in the center there. Looks like there is another one here also. Of course, the three there within the overall etheric archway, I would certainly suggest. further within the bush here, we have these two entranceways with with the trapezoid entrances. Also, in this case, the doorway to nowhere kind of recedes in. This one on a bit of an angle, and of course, this one here also. This shape is further up in the rock through here, and there are further entrances going in along here. So, in this case, a nice example of the entranceway going in. The last location was just through the bush there, and now up further, yet another doorway this time. Now, first up, there is a pit, so there was a possible underground aspect to what's going on here. But the detail here, it's very prominent, with a kind of doorway, around a doorway, with fascia-like work into the top. So, but again, this concentric doorway within a doorway, here, the various layers as seen with the camera. A concentric doorway within a doorway, Very quickly, tomb here. Now, it has the triptych doorway within. We'll have a quick look inside. Down here, it makes mention of sculpted legs being visible. Looking in here, I can't see that. We'll just have a close look inside, though, because you have the designs around the triptych type doorway in here. And then each of these rooms has the two areas at the sides like so. Some of this is very deteriorated. Interesting hole here. Okay, rolling the camera here, and we'll go through this doorway for an example, and you can see the markings, and into here designs. The wall looks like it's blown out, and then there's a further sort of region around here with areas going into the walls, etc., and then even up further in the bush up through here there are further areas. Okay, so you have this. So we have the doorway structure on the outside with the actual physical doorway going through in this case, and then in here to the rear of the wall it is repeated, in this case with no further avenue through for the physical body. In this case there is. It's repeated at the main doorway around the sides, so all four sides of the room in this case. We do have another chamber here off to the side. So all four sides of the room in this case. So tomb Sema, and on here there is talk within the wording of reproduction within the ceiling. Here is a plan. The greater construction is round, I believe. Here is an English write-up about the tomb. And just turning around now and heading in. So a various area in here, various area in here. Now this one of note with the ceiling design going into the center, so the kind of rays going into the center in a way, it's deteriorated. Also, with the pillars here, it's a bit like the doorways also. Very interesting, considering in this case, we have the pillars. And the same applies here and here. So just trying to capture the ceiling again to get an idea. There has been apparently some reconstruction work within here. We will now go through and into the next one. Again, various edifices, the ceiling, crisscross pattern in this case, although it's all hewn out of the one stone. There's been some reconstruction there, very recent, unfortunately, a bit of sturdiness to that with the iron bar, with the construction bar, but this one's much wider than many of the others. Steps up the back and a bit of a look in here. Backing out a bit, the ceiling here, there is the ribbing design in it also. Around here you have that doorway configuration with the doorway within a doorway, so to speak. All right, looks like the foundation to pillars just here. This is another aspect to this rounded construction, and within this one here, we've been into many of them, and many, there are just so many, but to this one, steps to the side, and interestingly enough, there are two curvatures here. To the other side, again, two curvatures there, quite small. In this case, just putting a tape measure across, and it's 81 centimeters from the wall to the edge of this construction at the side of this edifice.
Gordiace family.
Ah, this white one.
Even you even know his family.
Within the, by the stream here that's not really running at the moment, but there are plenty of rocks and there is a little bit of water just sitting in here. But just up above, there are the various entranceways in the rock, raised up within this huge rock. Like so. Here are those same places, and for a bit of reference, here are the local signs. There are many, many places within the bush. This is Tomb Portico, and there are three levels here. So you can see the stairway up through here. On the highest, or the higher level, three basic levels, and then proceeding down. And then around here also, so you have one, two, three levels. Within here, just going through and what is the second layer here, there's a layer above. Just to have a look at the where somebody has been tooling away in this case. So just trying to have a look at the detail there of the tooling. And here also, despite the odd bit of concrete and later interference, and you do get that with these sites, we'll come in here and noticing the curvature from this ancient site, there is no mortar used with the old bricks. And also to the sides here, you can see that the one stone has the curvature around the corner in this case. So quite a bit of skill to get these stones into place. Up here with this tuf of stone, you can see how the tree really rips through it.